just after daybreak, and there ain't going to be any paragliding this morning. Now this is a 30 amp drop cord. It plugs into the back of the brewery right here. And because of this pesky stationary front, which kept me from going out flying this morning, low visibility and misty conditions, not to mention the line of thunderstorms that parked over my practice area last night, means that I'm brewing beer this morning. There's nothing in the keyser. I haven't brewed beer since I started this paramotor adventure. So if I can't go flying, I'm going to make up an IPA, and maybe the weather will break a little bit. I'll be able to get out there and do flight number 2 this evening. Let there be beer.
Well, tonight is basic flight maneuvers night. You'll notice a reserve parachute. I'm not planning on any high G loading or any inverted flight or any even wingovers. I'm talking about straight and level flight, pitch changes, and basic turns, the basics of aviation. I'm a straight and level sightseeing guy, so it would require turbulence or my own actions or some other sort of catastrophe. I just feel more comfortable having the thing along than going flying without it. And I've routed the bridles up and over through the Velcro straps down onto auxiliary mallions that run through the most aft hookup point for the high hook in harness. And it's quite a learning curve. Putting that chute in that spandex yoga pants material bag is very difficult, but I got it done. I used a threader to get the little pieces of paracord underneath the plastic pullout deployment handles, and zips to the side of the APCO harness. And I think I have everything fared quite well. So put it to the test. O-rings over the mallions to keep the risers lined up. Everything else is pre-packed from the
Sure enough, by evening that night, the weather system had moved through. This was May 30th, 2017. The problem was that it didn't leave really nice air behind the stationary front. It wasn't a clean break. A lot of times after the frontal passage happens, the weather significantly improves, but here it's still kind of gusty and blustery. One of the biggest concerns when somebody's learning how to fly is that from a flight instruction standpoint, once they have significant success, you want to get them back up flying again. It's very important to reinforce the learning that occurred, the good habits that were formed, and further work through a building block, step-by-step process of getting to the next step, acquiring the next step of knowledge, and further ingraining what was done correctly. Unfortunately for me, social commitments, doctor's appointments, and other general life get in the way things kept me from getting back out to the field one or two times when the weather was good. And then I had a 5-day period when I just couldn't see getting out and going flying at my skill level. I want stable air, I want laminar wind flow, and I thought maybe, just maybe, it would work out this particular evening.
All right, I'm going to pick this up for just a second here.
typically later in the evenings, as the sun approaches the horizon, the thermal activity dies down and the wind gusts or sustained winds throughout the day become much more compliant, much more subdued. It wasn't the case this particular evening. I had convinced a young man that I'd helped get his commercial rating, who's now flying for a commuter airline, to accompany me and help with some video, hoping that I could get my second flight in. And basically, I had three opportunities, one of which was foiled by my own failure of holding the brake toggle. I dropped the toggle about 6 or 7 steps into the takeoff run and aborted. On the other two failures, I thought the winds were pretty much settled down from one direction, but about the time I decided to lift the glider and take a run, there was a 50-degree wind shift.
Well, see, now it's definitely south here. Too gusty.
So we waited. You can see here how much longer the shadows are. Even though we waited, it didn't make that big of a difference. In my mind, I had a pretty good idea of the profile that I had intended to fly this evening. I wanted to go out and make left turns, right turns.
See, here comes that gust again.
Uh-huh.
I wanted to make climbs and descents.
I mean, we deal with gusts all the time, right?
Sure.
And because of the feedback some of you had given me about possibly having brake lines that were too long, I wanted to get some video of the glider flying with the brakes stowed on the magnets and make some weight shift turns and see how it reacted, along with getting some actual video of just how much slack was in the brake lines with them stowed.
See, the other way to do it is the forward launch.
And lastly, I wanted to try manipulating my trim settings while in flight. My first flight had been with neutral trim settings, and that's where I had intended to take off on this particular evening. And I was going to try letting the trims out a little bit, move into the reflex mode. But we never got airborne.
Uh-oh.
Yep.
Right here, you can see that I didn't pay enough attention getting that brake toggle fully down into the space between my index finger and my middle finger. And I paid the price because this was a good inflation I could have easily flown from.
Dang it, I dropped the brake.
By this point in the evening, I'd had pretty much my fill of running around with the motor on my back and failed launches. I decided to come back out and try it again first thing in the morning today, which was June 1st, 2017. But I just wasn't comfortable with making a takeoff attempt by myself. I probably should have. It was a real nice morning, but I turned it into a kiting session and spent the morning reinforcing some better kiting skills, especially with forward launches. I took the glider down to my private airport and ran the length of the runway there 3 or 4 times. Never really had any problems at all. I probably could have even launched from the narrow spit of land between the runway and the taxiway there. But then again, I didn't have anybody there to help or to help with recovery or incidents or injuries. Well, my patience paid off. Waiting another day, came back to the field and found dead calm ground conditions and successfully inked flight number 2 into the logbook.
Well, I have to admit, I wish that there was a little bit more wind, especially after having had all of the wind the past couple days. All right, I'm going to start. Clear prop.
Of course, the first problem that I have here is that the mental image of the flight profile I wanted to demonstrate to myself or prove was thoroughly in my mind 24 hours ago. But to come out here again tonight, I had forgotten some of that. One of the hallmarks of professionalism in aviation is checklist discipline and checklist usage. I had taken from the MacPara glider manual and created a checklist that I also combined some items from online sources that I'd found for both the pre-flight and the takeoff and the landing. I made a mental memory tool to physically get out of the seat to attempt to shut the motor off.
I think I'm going to try to angle kind of towards the...
But I had done absolutely nothing to refresh my memory about the goals that I had intended to attain by conducting the flight this evening. So from now on, I will use a checklist type device for in-flight as much as I do for on the ground here in the prep phase. So the best I can tell what happened here was, although the ground winds were absolutely zero, 10 or 12 feet in the air, they were slightly out of the north, and I tried to launch toward the west, but turns out I needed to go more straight north. When I pulled the glider up here, as soon as it got into the moving air, it wanted to twist into the relative wind, and I couldn't run fast enough or correct fast enough to make it work out. I had also wanted to validate the Fly Sky High software that I'd downloaded from my smartphone, but trying to keep everything in synchronization here and working with limited battery and media storage, I forgot to start that as well. Probably should have started it and just let it run the whole time, but I thought I could do it right before takeoff. Although I've personally never had any professional test pilot training, I have, across the train wreck of my flying career, been asked to conduct some flight tests from time to time. Almost always, those profiles have everything constant to test or find out or validate one particular item. I had 7 or 8 things that I wanted to demonstrate on this flight, and after a failed launch, keeping all of that in the forefront of my mind is very, very difficult. I need to use a checklist for that too. Explanation for that little reduction in power right at liftoff was apparently I eased up on the throttle just enough to let the engine spool down right about takeoff time. But the good news is I continued to run throughout the takeoff, and I did not jump into the air like it did on my first departure.
having video, in spite of its poor quality here, for debriefing and reviewing how the flight went is extremely invaluable. Both the video from the ground and the video taken from the air has taught me an awful lot by reviewing it and watching it and taking a look at where my control inputs are, how the wing is flying, what I did technique-wise correctly and what I've done wrong, and where to go from here. I will say that I think that when the trimmers are set at neutral or full, hauled all the way in, there's way too much slack in the brakes, especially as I tried to flare tonight and more or less ran out of flare authority. It is fully possible that I completely stalled the wing just a few inches too early in the flare. apparent hackle or tangle in the wingtip steering stabilo line caused me quite a bit of concern on the flight. However, the wing was responding correctly to my brake inputs, and I didn't pull hard on it to see if I could get it to untangle. It will definitely get another inspection while being kited before I go flying again. I took a real close look at it after landing and couldn't see anything abnormal with the lines. I've decided I'm taking today off from aviation. I'm headed to the big box electronics store to pick up some better camera gear and some mic equipment so that I can think, talk, and video while I'm flying. After I accidentally shut the video off here, I was able to accomplish a few more things, mostly adjusting those tremors slightly. And that's a good confidence builder, but I came back for a landing with them all the way in, and the landing was not very spectacular.